facts of Amelia Earhart and Fred Noonan's disappearance remain a mystery to this day.
Nobody knows what happened to them or their aircraft. And looking for a plane in the ocean is kind of like searching for a needle in a haystack.
Over the years, people have tried to find evidence of her Lockheed Electra, tracking down leads and considering conspiracy theories. But so far, nothing concrete has been found.
But this doesn't mean the search has stopped. And one group is trying to pinpoint where the plane went down and solve this mystery once and for all.
Since 1999, a group of Amelia Earhart enthusiasts and retired radio engineers have been looking at the communication systems Earhart used on her final flight and breaking down the performance of each in order to help future searches.
In the Earhart mystery, as she's approaching Howland Island, she makes several radio transmissions by analyzing how strong the signal is and a bunch of other parameters, technical parameters about the airplane and the radios she used and the radios on the Itasca. We should be able to determine the distance that the plane was from the island during these various radio transmissions.
Before these radio experiments, this was accomplished using computer modeling.
Well, one of the big questions is, can you trust the computer program? How do we know it represents reality?
Obtaining and restoring all of the scarce 1937 equipment prevented these kinds of tests until now.
It's hard to find some of this old equipment. For one thing, it was very expensive back in the 30s. They didn't make very many of them, and then even fewer of them survive today.
The crucial piece of equipment was a Western electronic transmitter. It is one of the only ones still in existence. It was restored and filled a crucial gap to implementing the tests. The team also needed two more critical items, an aircraft similar to Earhart's Lockheed Electra and a seagoing vessel to simulate the U.S. Coast Guard cutter Itasca. Dynamic Aviation offered the use of a Beech-18 aircraft as well as technical support.
The look of the two airplanes is very, very similar. Because of that, we can put the same style V antenna on the airplane and have the same kind of engine noise and background that would have been present when she made her transmissions.
It's important to understand Amelia Earhart, her thinking, what got her to the place where she was willing to take what was acknowledgeably high risks.
The dynamic aviation airplane, Miss Amelia, had to be configured with equipment racks, HF antenna, and a rare direction finding loop antenna provided by Nauticos. During the recreation of Amelia Earhart's last flight, the engineers measured the signal strengths and distances for each of her last transmissions.
Beautiful scenery out today. The airplane's looking good.
In order to accommodate the radio gear that matched the U.S. Coast Guard cutter Itasca, they selected the Nellie Crockett, a Chesapeake Bay oyster boat built in 1925. The team from Dynamic Aviation, Nauticos, and the Nellie Crockett came together in mid-September 2020 to bring the radio test to life.
What this all comes down to is the complete process of the scientific method, the fact that you're starting with a hypothesis and you make it full circle all the way down to the beginning, where you start back with the questions that you started with and go back to another hypothesis to try to figure it out. And all of this, although we're using different pieces of science in different areas, all of this comes together through the scientific process.
The test provided critical data about the radio transmissions between the Lockheed Electra and the Itasca during her final hours, ultimately validating the computer models that had been used to guide the previous searches. These tests will help future explorers to narrow the search area as the pursuit to find Earhart's Lockheed Electra continues.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.